Ladies and gentlemen, the first feature is called text found in photos. What I mean by that is very simple yet powerful. We can search 1000 things in Spotlight. And specifically, there are different ways to search an image. By the description of the photo, or the location, or even what's in the photo. But if there is any kind of text in that photo, you can find that photo by typing that text. How insane is that, right? I mean, it even highlights that text in the pic for reference. And let me tell you, all the tricks that are upcoming are cool and you may even know some, but you definitely wouldn't know where to use them. Sounds interesting? Then what are we waiting for? Let's dive straight into it, shall we? So where were we? Photos, right? One more trick here. When you long press on the Photos app, these are some options. All of them are super useful and one of them is favorites. Right, but a trick here is if you share or need some pictures very often, so instead of creating a dedicated folder for them, simply add those kind of pics in favorites and quickly access them with this trick. Speaking about finding, sometimes it's confusing to determine whether a photo is portrait or landscape. Now in any of your album, tap on the three dots and select aspect ratio. Every photo will display exactly how it is from now on. There is a reader mode in Safari, right? I think most of you know that. It lets you read peacefully without ads and stuff. But the best part is, you can share or save an article without even enabling the reader mode. All you have to do is share, and you will see a tiny options thing here. Tap on that and select Reader PDF. Now that article will be shared like it was in reader mode. That too in a PDF format. How cool is that? Let's take a look. And there we have it. There are some times when you enable Do Not Disturb mode or your iPhone is on silent, but you are going to get an important call. So instead of breaking your Do Not Disturb mode, open the contact, edit, ringtone, and enable emergency bypass. You can even set custom ringtone or vibration for any contact. You don't need to enable emergency bypass for that. If you are enjoying, leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. When you have multiple apps running, you know we can navigate, swiping left and right on the bar at the bottom. But even on the home screen, if you swipe to the left at the bottom, like if there was a bar, you'll go on the most recent app. Likewise, iPhone doesn't allow us to close multiple apps together in multitask like with Android. But instead of closing them one by one, you can use two or three fingers and close two or three apps together. Swipe up with all three fingers together and three apps close together. With iOS 15, if you have trouble reading something in a particular app, Notes app for example, so rather than increasing the text size everywhere on your iPhone, which looks disastrous by the way, you can increase the size of that particular app from Control Center. Long press on text size and it'll give an option for the app you're currently on. If you don't have text size here, from settings in Control Center, add it and you are good to go. Moving forward, tags are a very effective way of organizing on iPhone. We have two apps where tags can change lives. First is but obvious the Notes app. You can add multiple tags inside the note itself, as many as you want, and then go all the way back. All new tags have been automatically added here. Now you can search notes using a single tag or make it advanced by adding more tags. Likewise, the second app is the Files app. The best way to find something is using tags. Let's create a tag first, long press, then tags, and instead of remembering the color, I prefer to give tags names with a color. So with this, no matter in which folder or what type your file is, you can easily find them by searching using that tag, and everything related to the tag pops here instantly. Okay, you know Files is a very important app now. To add on, if you have a Files widget, if not, let's add one quickly. Firstly, we can access files using tags we just created. Long press and select, edit files, and choose the tag. Main part is with the latest version of iOS 15, we can easily drag and drop the file directly from the widget to wherever you want to send it. Wait for it, and there we go. If you have lots of pages on your home screen, instead of swiping, we can use these dots to navigate. But if you directly want to go to the home page, to the first page, just swipe up like we do for multitask, but a little faster, and you'll directly come to the home page. Well, that's the end of the 10 useful features for iPhone. Leave a like if you learned something new and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching. My name is Mufaddal. This is Apple Vibes. Take care, and I will see you in the next video.